What is the biggest sacrifice that you have ever done in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, my dear listeners. InshaAllah today I'll be sharing with you all a little bit about sacrifices done in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in this particular case, from the story of our dear prophets Ibrahim alayhi salam and his son Ismail alayhi salam. So we can see in the Quran, in Surah As-Saffat verse 102, where Allah said, فَلَمَّا بَلَوَ مَأْهُ سَعْيَا, which means, and when Ismail alayhi salam reached the age of exertion, which means when Ismail alayhi salam becomes a young adult who is now capable of doing things on his own, right? Able to stand on his own two feet. Ibrahim came up to him and then say, يَا بُنَيَّ, my dear son, إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَزْبَهُكَ, verily, truly, I see in a dream that I sacrifice you. Fanzur maza tara, so tell me, what do you see of this? And Ismail answered, Qala ya abatif al ma tu'mar, my dear father, do as that which you have been commanded. Satajiduni insha'allahu minas sabirin, for verily you will find me to be amongst those who are steadfast, those who are patient with the command of Allah. Let's take a step back here and look at things from the side of Ismail. Imagine someone came up to you and tell you that you have to give up your life to fulfill a command of God. Will you be able to do that? But that, my dear listeners, is exactly what Ismail is doing over here. When his father came up to him and tell him that I have to sacrifice you because I saw that in a dream, that is something that Allah told me to do. Ismail readily agreed. Qala ya abatif al ma tu'mar, my dear father, just do as that which God has commanded. Satajiduni insha'allahu minas sabirin, for you will truly find me to be amongst the patient and the steadfast. How many of us will be able to be truly patient and steadfast upon upholding this religion of Allah to the degree that we will willingly sacrifice ourselves, our own lives? Now, let us take a look on the other side, from the point of view of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Over here, Ibrahim saw in his dream that he sacrificed his son Ismail. And Ismail is not just any son. As I'm pretty sure some of us may have known, Ibrahim had never had any children before Ismail. He was married for a long time to Sarah and they never had any children. And finally, when he have Ismail, one of the first things that Allah actually commanded Ibrahim to do when Ismail reached adulthood is to sacrifice him. How many of us parents will be able to do that? All in the name of Allah. How many of us will be willing to go the extra mile to sacrifice whatever we have, our whole soul, everything, all in the name of Allah? That, my dear listeners, is the question that I put up to you all for today. Hopefully, we can learn something from the piety of Ibrahim and Ismail as they willingly sacrifice everything they hold dear in the name of Allah. May whatever I have shared today be of benefit to us all, and Allah knows best. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Terima kasih kerana telah menonton video kami hingga ke akhirnya. Anda bolehlah mengikuti kami di laman-laman sosial seperti Instagram, Facebook dan YouTube. Jika anda ada sebarang komen, bolehlah like dan komen di bawah ini.